नमस्ते टू एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब वीडियो चैनल। टुडे आई विल डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन कॉम्प्लेक्स एनालिसिस, लेक्चर नंबर 2, व्हिच विल इंक्लूड द पोलर फॉर्म ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, वेक्टर फॉर्म ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर, ज्योमेट्री ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स एंड सो ऑन। नाउ वी रिप्रेजेंट कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इन पोलर फॉर्म। लेट जेड इक्वल टू एक्स प्लस आई वाई बी ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इन ऑर्डर, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ऑर्डर्ड पेयर। We may represent this as xy. Let us draw two axes. OX axis, this is the real axis, and OY axis, this is imaginary axis. Then the ordered pair xy is represented by the point P in Argand plane. Let us join OP, and OP equal to R, OA equal to X, AP equal to Y, angle X OP equal to theta. Therefore, OA by OP equal to, this is perpendicular, OA by OP equal to cos theta implies that OA equal to OP cos theta equal to R cos theta. Here OA equal to X, again AP by OP equal to sin theta implies that AP equal to OP sin theta implies that AP is Y equal to R sin theta. Now X square plus Y square equal to R square cos square theta plus R square sin square theta equal to R square cos square theta plus sin square theta. This is R square into 1 equal to R square. Therefore, R equal to square root X square plus Y square. As we take R is always positive, so here we may give the sign positive. This R is called, R is called modulus of Z, and we denote modulus Z equal to R. Theta is called amplitude. Theta is called amplitude or argument of Z. Here theta is written as theta equal to tan inverse Y by X. as if we divide y by x, r sin theta by r cos theta. So right side tan theta equal to y by x and theta equal to tan inverse y by x. We may write here r sin theta by r cos theta equal to y by x implies that tan theta equal to y by x and theta equal to tan inverse y by x. Here we see that this angle is theta. OP makes angle theta with x axis. If we go anti-clockwise direction and again we reach OP, so we will get no change. Position of OP remains the same and this angle is 2 pi. This movement is 2 pi. Again, if we move, then come to the same position, then we will get again 2 pi. So amplitude may be written as theta, may be written as argument or amplitude. Argument z may be written as theta plus 2n pi. N equal to 1, 2, dot, dot, dot. Now, we see that z equal to x plus iy. X is r cos theta plus I r sin theta. We take common r cos theta plus I sin theta. This cos theta plus I sin theta is e to the power I theta. So the complex number z be represented in the form of r e to the power I theta. In generalized way, we may write that r e to the power I theta into e to the power 2n pi I, as 2n pi I is 1. This means cos 2n pi plus I sin 2n pi. So we may also write this as r e to the power 2n pi plus theta I in generalized form. So this is the polar representation of a complex number. Now we represent complex number in vector form. We have seen that the complex number in polar form, in which we saw that the complex number z is represented by the point P in Argand plane, such that OP makes angle theta with x axis and OP equal to R, XOP angle equal to theta. Both OP equal to R and angle XOP equal to theta may be represented by a single thing, that is vector OP. So vector OP represents the कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड. हियर मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ओपी इक्वल टू आर. सो इट इज वेरी इजी दैट द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय ए सिंगल वेक्टर. दिस वेक्टर रिप्रेजेंट्स द मैग्नीट्यूड एज वेल एज डायरेक्शन ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड. नाउ वी शैल गिव एन वन एग्जाम्पल. इफ द आर्गुमेंट इज पाई बाई टू देन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज प्योरली इमेजिनरी. बट इफ द आर्गुमेंट इज जीरो और पाई देन द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज प्योरली रियल. वी शैल हैव टू प्रूव दिस. लेट जेड बी ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर सच दैट मॉडुलस ऑफ जेड इक्वल टू आर एंड आर्गुमेंट जेड इक्वल टू थीटा. देन इन पोलर फॉर्म वी मे राइट पोलर फॉर्म वी मे राइट जेड इक्वल टू आर कॉस थीटा प्लस आई आर साइन थीटा. दिस इज एक्स. आर कॉस थीटा इज एक्स प्लस आई आर साइन थीटा इज वाई. सो हियर इफ वी टेक इफ आर्गुमेंट थीटा थीटा एम्पलीट्यूड और आर्गुमेंट यू आर गिवेन दैट आर्गुमेंट. आर्गुमेंट इज थीटा इक्वल टू पाई बाई टू. देयरफॉर जेड इक्वल टू आर कॉस पाई बाई टू प्लस आई आर साइन पाई बाई टू. आर कॉस पाई बाई टू इज जीरो. आई आर साइन पाई बाई टू इज वन. दिस इज इक्वल टू जीरो प्लस आई आर इक्वल टू आई आर. आर इज ए रियल नंबर एंड आई इज इमेजिनरी नंबर. दिस इज इक्वल टू प्योरली इमेजिनरी नंबर. If argument equal to theta equal to 0, then z equal to r cos 0 plus I r sin 0. This is r equal to 1 cos 0 1. I r sin 0 is 0. This is r plus 0 equal to r. This belongs to a real number, so it is a purely real, a purely real number. If argument z equal to theta equal to pi, then z equal to r cos pi plus I r sin pi. Cos pi is minus 1 r into minus 1. I r sin pi is 0. So this is minus r. This is purely real. So equal to purely real number. Now we solve a problem, prove that real
part of Z1, Z2 equal to real part of Z1 multiply real part of Z2 minus imaginary part of Z1 into imaginary part of Z2. Let the complex numbers Z1 and Z2 be represented in polar form as Z1 equal to R1 e to the power I theta 1, where mod Z1 equal to R1 and argument Z1 equal to theta 1. Similarly, Z2 equal to R2 e to the power I theta 2, where mod Z2 equal to R2, argument of Z2 equal to theta 2. We may write here Z1 equal to R1 e to the power I theta 1 means cos theta 1 plus I sin theta 1. And here also Z2 equal to R2 e to the power I theta 2 is cos theta 2 plus I sin theta 2. We multiply by R1, R1 cos theta 1 plus I R1 sin theta 1. Here also similarly, R2 cos theta 2 plus I R2 sin theta 2. Here we see that real part of Z1 is this, R1 cos theta 1. Imaginary part of Z1 is R1 sin theta 1. Real part of Z2 is R2 cos theta 2 and imaginary part of Z2 is R2 sin theta 2. So, we write according to the given problem, real Z1, real Z2 minus imaginary Z1 multiply imaginary Z2. Real Z1 is R1 cos theta 1, real Z2 is R2 cos theta 2 minus imaginary Z1 R1 sin theta 1, imaginary Z2 R2 sin theta 2. We take here common R1 multiply by R2. So cos theta 2 minus sin theta 1 sin theta 2. Cos, this is cos theta 1 plus theta 2. This is number 1. Now we write Z1 multiply by Z2. Z1 is R1 e to the power I theta 1. Z2 is R2 e to the power I theta 2. Here R1 multiply by R2 and we add the powers of the same base e to the power I common theta 1 plus theta 2. So this equal to R1 R2. E to the power I theta 1 plus theta 2 is cos theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I sin theta 1 plus theta 2. We multiply this and we get R1 R2 cos theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I R1 R2 sin theta 1 plus theta 2. Here real part of Z1 Z2 is this. Real part of Z1 Z2 is R1 R2 cos theta 1 plus theta 2. This is number 2. From 1 and 2, we see that right side equal. So left side will be equal. So real of Z1 Z2 equal to real of Z1 multiply real of Z2 minus imaginary part Z1 imaginary into imaginary part Z2. Proved. Now we shall solve another problem. Imaginary Z1 Z2 equal to real Z1 imaginary Z2 plus real Z1 imaginary Z real Z2 imaginary Z1. Let the complex number Z1 and Z2 be represented in polar form as Z1 equal to R1 e to the power I theta 1, Z2 equal to R2 e to the power I theta 2 respectively, where modulus of Z1 equal to R1, argument of Z1 equal to theta 1, and modulus of Z2 equal to R2, argument of Z2 equal to theta 2. Now, this Z1 equal to R1 e to the power I theta 1 equal to cos theta 1 plus I sin theta 1. Now, Z2 equal to r2 e to the power I theta 2 is cos theta 2 plus I sin theta 2. So we multiply r1, r1 cos theta 1 plus I r1 sin theta 1. Here we multiply r2, r2 cos theta 2 plus I r2 sin theta 2.
So real part of z1 is r1 cos theta 1. Imaginary part of z1 is r1 sin theta 1. Real part of z2 is r2 cos theta 2. Imaginary part of z2 equal to r2 sin theta 2. Now we write real z1 imaginary z1 plus real z2 imaginary z1. We write real z1 is r1 cos theta 1, imaginary z1 z2 equal to r2 sin theta 2. Real z2 is r2 cos theta 2, imaginary z1 equal to r1 sin theta 1. We take common r1 in multiply by r2. Here remains cos theta 1 sin theta 2 plus cos theta 2 sin theta 1. This is sin theta 1 plus theta 2. This is number 1.
Now z1 multiply by z2 is r1 e to the power I theta 1 multiply by r2 e to the power I theta 2. This is equal to r1 multiply by r2. We take here base e same. So we add the powers I theta 1 plus theta 2. So this is equal to r1 r2. This will be equal to cos theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I sin theta 1 plus theta 2. Now we take imaginary z1 z2. This is imaginary z1 z2. So this will be r1 r2 sin theta 1 plus theta 2. From 1 and 2 we see that right side equal, so therefore left side will be equal. So imaginary z1 z2 equal to real z1 into multiply imaginary z2 plus real z2 multiply by imaginary z1. Proved. Now we shall describe the geometry of sum of two complex numbers. Let z1 equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 equal to x2 plus iy2 be two complex numbers. In the terms of ordered pair, z1 is represented by the ordered pair x1, y1 and z2 is represented by ordered pair x2, y2. Here z1 plus z2, sum of two ordered pairs equal to x ordered pair x1 plus x2 comma y1 plus y2. Now we describe about the geometry of the sum. In Argand plane, the z1 and z2 are represented by the points P and Q respectively. Let us join OP and OQ and construct a parallelogram OPRQ. As adjacent side OP and OQ. Here OP and OP equal to QR and also OP parallel to QR. Similarly, OQ equal to PR and OQ is parallel to PR. Here we see that the coordinates of the point P be x1, y1 and coordinates of the point Q be x2, y2. Therefore, middle point of the diagonal PQ will be the coordinate x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. As this is a parallelogram, OPRQ is a parallelogram. So the diagonals will bisect with each other. So S be the point of intersection of two diagonals. So S be the middle point of two diagonals. So coordinates of S will be x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Here we see that the coordinates of the origin be 0, 0 and coordinates of the middle point of OR be x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Therefore, coordinates of R must be x1 plus x2, comma y1 plus y2. The point R will represent the complex number z1 plus z2. In vector form, we may also represent this, the point R, as the sum of two complex numbers. In vector form, we know that vector OP represent z1 and vector OQ represent z2. As vector OP equal to vector QR and vector OQ equal to vector PR and OP plus PR equal to vector OR, OP is Z1 and PR, PR is OQ, OQ means Z2 and this is OR, OR means here OR vector, this is Z1 plus Z2, that is R represents, the point R represents the complex number Z1 plus Z2. Now we shall describe the geometry of difference of two complex numbers. Let Z1 equal to X1 plus IY1 and Z2 equal to X2 plus IY2 be two complex numbers. In the form of ordered pair, they may be written as Z1 equal to ordered pair X1 Y1 and Z2 equal to ordered pair X2 Y2. Implies that Z1 minus Z2 equal to ordered pair X1 minus X2 comma Y1 minus Y2. Let we describe the geometry. Let point P and Q represent the complex number Z1 and Z2 respectively. The coordinates of the point P be X1, Y1 and coordinates of the point Q be X2, Y2. Let us join OP and OQ and we extend QO up to Q dash such that OQO equal to OQ dash. Therefore, QO equal to OQ dash and direction of QO and OQ dash be same. Therefore, the coordinates of Q dash will be minus X2, Y2. That is, Q dash represents the complex number minus Z2. Now, let us construct a parallelogram with adjacent side OP and OQ dash. This parallelogram is OQ dash RP. Here we get diagonals OR and Q dash P. The coordinates of the point P be X1, Y1 and coordinates of point Q dash be minus X2, Y2. Therefore, middle point of the diagonal PQ dash will be X1 minus X2 by 2 and y1 minus y2 by 2, middle point. We know that in parallelogram, the diagonals bisect with each other. So, let here S be the point of intersection of two diagonals. Therefore, S will be the middle points of two diagonals. Therefore, coordinates of S will be x1 minus x2 by 2 and y1 minus y2 by 2. We have obtained this value from the diagonals PQ dash. Now, let us use the diagonal OR. The coordinates of OB 0, 0.
Here 0, 0.
And coordinates of SB x1 minus x2 by 2 and y1 minus y2 by 2. Therefore, the coordinates of R must be x1 minus x2, comma y1 minus y2. Only for this property, the middle point will be x1 minus x2 by 2 and y1 minus y2 by 2. Therefore, point R will represent the complex number z1 minus z2 as the coordinates of R is x1 minus x2 comma y1 minus y2. Here we see that RP equal to OQ because we have constructed this parallelogram. So this is parallel to this and OQ dash equal to in magnitude OQ. So this Q dash O equal to RP. So RP will be equal to OQ and also parallel. So ORPQ will be a parallelogram. Hence the side OR and QP will be parallel and also equal. Now we may say that OQ equal to and parallel QP implies that the complex number Z1 minus Z2 will be represented by QP. In vector form, we may also see that this is vector Z1, OP equal to Z1, OQ equal to vector Z2, then OQ vector plus QP vector equal to OQ plus QP equal to OP vector. QP vector will be equal to OP vector minus OQ vector. OP is Z1 and OQ is Z2 in terms of complex number. So, complex number Z1 minus Z2 is represented by QP vector. Thanks for watching my video. If you are satisfied with my presentation and contents, then please click on like button and do subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.